What is a cue sheet? A cue sheet is a written log that lists all of the music used in a television show, film, or audiovisual production. Why is the cue sheet important for you to understand? It's important because it ensures that all of the songwriting, publishing, and artist information listed on the cue sheet is correct. Once the producers of the show or staff member or whomever is designated to fill out this information, once it's finished, they send the cue sheets to the performing rights organizations. This is the main or primary way that performing rights organizations track the use of the music that was used in the film or TV show or documentary. So if you ever have an opportunity to sing and perform on a television show or movie, or your music is used in any of those productions, when the opportunity presents itself and you have a music publisher or a music publishing administrator, please let them know immediately so that they can ensure that all of that information is properly filled out on the cue sheet. If you are self-publishing, doing it yourself, then you make sure that that information is taken care of. So when do you need a cue sheet? Well, you don't have to worry about it if you're doing personal videos like I'm doing here on YouTube or Vimeo, or you may do a corporate video or have some on your website, for example. But you definitely need the cue sheet for public broadcasting on television, like we say at film, movies, live theater, or for documentaries. Let's take a look at the information that's used on a cue sheet and what they send in. Now, there are many various forms of cue sheets, but I'm using a cue sheet courtesy of film sourcing and storyboard music. The information contained in the top, the production title, production length, and the rest of the information here, which is pretty much self-explanatory. Then if you look down where you have to fill in the other information, the sequence and cue number, you do it in order. So it would be, let's say, sequence cue number one. Put the name of the cue, your song title, the name of the artist, and then the name of the master rights owner or the master licensor, the composer's name, percentage of ownership, performing rights affiliation, the name of the publisher and their percentage, their PRO affiliation, which should be the same as the composer's, the type of use. You'll see the usages on the right side over there where it reads legend use type. Was it a background instrumental? Was it a background vocal? Was it a visual instrumental? Was it a featured vocal? Was it an opening or closing theme? These all specify usage type. So once they determine that type, the corresponding abbreviation would then go in for type of use, and then the duration. How long did it last? Your job or the publisher's job would be to ensure, like we said earlier, that the names, songwriters, publishing information, percentage information is all accurately reflected on the cue sheet. Let's look at another one. This cue sheet is set up completely different, but yet contains most of the same information as you can see here, just formatted in a different way. Some cue sheets have an in and out. For example, what time did the song actually start? Could be 30 seconds into it. When did it end? If it ends at 1 minute, then we know the song duration is 30 seconds long. Be sure to subscribe and hit that notification bell for more music business tips. Pick up your free checklist. Stay well and safe, and have a great day.